Okay, my bad, guys. All right, what's up? Back for episode number 3. If you guys didn't know, that song is from Back to the Future, made in 1989. I absolutely love Back to the Future. Shout out to my dad. He introduced me to this series when I was younger. It's a classic. You know, the movie, I just love that movie. You know, that song is in there, The Power of Love by Huey Lewis and the News. You know, you're a slacker, hood. I don't think you even know what I'm talking about, do you? You're a slacker, McFly. But you know, today's episode, we want to really dive into the different types of love. There's so many different types of love. You know, there's brotherly love, sisterly love, parental love, or I guess parental love, however you guys say it, wherever you're from. Relational love, you know, meaning like your girlfriend or your boyfriend or spouse, that really deep relationship. I mean, there's so many different types of love, and we just want to dive into it. So I'm going to start off with prayer, then Hud's going to get us rolling with something he wrote that was actually from 2017, yeah, way back when.
Ninth grade,
getting some notes on love. So anyways, you know, bow your head wherever you're at. Father God, thank you so much for this amazing day. You know, today is Easter. It's such an amazing day, you know, the most important day in human history. Thank you so much for your son who died on the cross for us and rose 3 days later. Yeah. Thank you so much for that unconditional and amazing love that he showed us. Lord, thank you. Help us today. Help us to forgive somebody as we forgive those who have sinned against us, Lord. Just help us to be unconditional lovers and to show that amazing type of love that your son has shown to us and that you've shown to us, Lord. And whoever's listening right now, help them to, you know, open their ears and just really receive what we're trying to put out there and just share, Lord. Help us to love unconditionally and help us to, you know, just do our best for you each day, Lord. I love you so much. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
All right, I was going to dive into, I actually did write this in ninth grade. I was looking back in my journal and I was like, man, this is perfect.
Back when we were some studs in football.
Studs, right? Man. And then I got Paul saying, if I have faith to move mountains, but I have no love, then I mean nothing. Mm. Without love, nothing matters. Love is all you need because God is love. It is the most important thing God gave to the church. Love. It is demonstrated by patience. Love is kind. It is gentle to all. It cares for everyone. It is way more than being nice. Mm-hmm. Love does not envy nor have jealousy. We should not do either because we are so lucky as it is. We should not be focused on anyone else but focused on God. If you're to boast, boast in the Lord. Love does not keep a record of wrongs.
That's deep.
Love is forgiveness, dude.
Bro, yeah, and, you know, I want to touch on that a little. You know, whatever it is, like, you know, you might, like, there might be someone when you were younger or somebody just in general that just really, really, like, has done some bad things to you or, like, you know, like, in your life, and that's honestly where real love comes in. Like, it doesn't come, you know, from those that we, you know, have a great relationship with. Like, knowing what real love is and when you are able to love those that really can't, like, give you anything in return, I guess, or that even are giving you bad things in return. So, you know, and I want to, like, what I want to go into now is Jesus showed us the ultimate form of love by dying for us on Easter. Today is Easter, which means that today is the day that love won.
Yeah.
Jesus defeated death and our sins were forgiven. He made the ultimate sacrifice of love and grace for us. I mean, if you truly understand that, then, like, I promise you'll want to love God more.
The love God has for us and how powerful it is crazy, man.
I swear, bro.
To take on our sins, to do the things we could not do, mm-hmm. that he did not deserve.
Yeah, I mean, he didn't deserve that at all. I mean, he was literally perfect. Like dude was literally perfect, never did anything wrong. I mean, a sinless man, and he decided to die for us. I mean, that's really crazy if you think about it. Like, that's, you can't comprehend, you can't fathom the amount of love that has, like, the power of love. And now we're going to go into another topic, which is love is a choice. So, like, okay, when you wake up in the morning, like, you either choose love, or I don't want to say you choose something else, but, like, you know, it's literally just a choice. Like, when you wake up, I mean, and I want to dive into this topic, or not this topic, I want to dive into this quote from NF, you know, for all you guys that don't know, NF is the GOAT.
No, I don't know about that. He's good. He's good.
You don't think he's a GOAT?
Yeah, I don't think he's the GOAT.
Who's a GOAT?
It's going to have to be Lecrae.
Lecrae? Dude. Okay, maybe. Yeah. Maybe Lecrae is the GOAT. But, okay, I think as far as being real, like, NF, you know, he just keeps it more real than anyone. you know, we might have to argue about that later. But anyways, you know, NF said something that really stuck out to me and that opened my eyes. He said, "What's the point in having blood with no veins? What's the point in having love with no pain?" So basically what that's saying is that real and genuine unconditional love is not easy. Like it's not easy at all. I mean, it, like, you literally can't, like, fathom what that is, honestly, because it's like you literally have to have pain in order to get something you want. Like, in order to have something that's worth keeping, you know, it takes you working hard for.
Exactly, dude. I mean, and if love was easy, then it wouldn't be as powerful as it is.
For sure. I mean, no question.
A lot of relationships go through hard times, struggles, mm-hmm. everything like that, and love will prevail if it's their number one priority.
Right. Love will always drive out fear. No question.
No question about it, because if you have God in the center of your life, then you have love in the center of your life.
Mm-hmm.
And those go hand in hand.
Yeah, and I mean, and like I said, you know, with that, I mean, how do you love the people that don't love you back? Like, how do you love that person that gives you a dirty look? Like, you know, you're at the gym, you're just freaking bumping, and yeah, and then they look at you and they're like, "You're weak, bro. Like, you know,
my PR is better than
you." Yeah, they try to get in your head. Like, I don't know, just those people that are just always jerks to you, and that you just kind of look at them and, like, why are you being so mean? But I mean, like, what do you do whenever those people look at you and they, you know, they're derogative towards you, or they're mean, or just in anything in life in general? You know, you go to class, you get that class bully or whatever.
I think, in a way, that how are you going to show God if you're not showing love?
For sure.
You might be the only opportunity somebody sees God. And if you're not showing his love, then why would anybody want to be a part of that? If you're just going with the flow, you're going with this or that. Nah. If you got God in the center of your life, you're showing love. That's period, man.
Yeah, and, bro, do you remember in FCA camp in ninth grade, the Woodlawn movie we watched?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, okay. Okay, so whenever we were in the ninth grade, their FCA produced a movie called Woodlawn. It was based on a true story, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
So, you know, I think it's in Alabama, you know, based in Alabama, and there's, like, this high school, and it's whenever they started to segregate schools. Like, they started to,
Yeah, they segregated the schools.
Or would it, would it be they segregated them, or they stopped segregation? I don't know, either way.
Oh, no, they did integrate them eventually.
Yeah, either way, my bad. Either way, they put the, like, you know, the white kids and the black kids together, and, you know, there was a really, really good football player that started playing at this school. He was a stud, and he was black. And the coach is white. And, you know, all season long, these kids, like, the black kids on the team, they got treated awful. You know, they got people calling them, you know, awful slurs, like, awful names and stuff. And they had trouble. Like, you know, they were trying their best because, you know, if they did anything dumb, like, they'd get kicked out. Or if they did anything, you know, that could, like, hurt their team, you know, like, they're going to, you know, get suspended or whatever.
The slightest thing.
The slightest thing. And so their coach one day, he was saying, you know, he always told him, he said, "You got to love those people. You got to love those people. You got to love those people." And then one time a player got super mad and he looked at him and he's like, "Why do I have to love them? Why? They spit at me. They hate me. They kick at me. They call me racist names." He's like, "Why in the world would I ever want to love somebody that hates me and that does that to me. And he said, well, I'll tell you this. If you only love those that love you back, then what kind of love is that? And dude, that has stuck with me ever since then. And I've always like really loved that quote. And it's just really stuck with me. And I've thought that all the time, you know, because I've thought like, okay, if I only love those that love me back, what kind of love is that? And I just feel like it's real. Like, if you truly love somebody, no matter what they've done to you, like, if somebody has just done the most awful thing in the world to you and you look at them and smile and say, hey, I love you, like, bro, that affects people different.
Oh, it does. It touches people on a different level because...
That's the power of love, man.
When you show love when there's no love given shown, you're showing God, exactly.
Like, right.
And it goes into a kind of deeper, unconditional love.
Yeah, and I wanted to talk about that. Like, there's two different, like, to me personally, you know, I mean, I know there's a multiple different types of love, but to me, there's two different types of, like, love, I guess. I don't want to say between two people, but two different types of love in general, and it's mutual love and unconditional love. And Hud, talk to me about what that mutual love is.
I think mutual love between two people is when you love someone and they love you back.
Yeah.
So you love each other more, and it's really like love between you mm-hmm. and someone. Like being around them, you both feel like you're building each other up.
Right.
And it's just, it's growing together.
Yeah. Bro, do you ever, in science, when we were younger, did you ever hear about, like, the symbiotic relationship and the mutual relationship between, like, animals or whatever?
Man, I'm pretty sure I was sleeping, dude.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, anyways, that's beside the point. But, like, they talked about in class about how, like, the mutual relationship is, like, when they're both benefiting from something. So, like... I don't want to get into it, but it's just like basically animals like work together to benefit with each other. And so that's what you would describe as a mutual relationship. If you are doing something good and someone else is doing something good and it makes you guys better and it like multiplies, that's what mutual love is.
And then unconditional love, the way it differs from that is it's a type of love that's everlasting. I mean, this mutual love is great and it's awesome to have with people. But that's not forever.
Right.
That unconditional love that God has bestowed in our lives, mm-hmm. that's forever.
Yeah.
And if you're going to love somebody with all you have and all your power, then that's...
Yeah. I know exactly what you're saying.
You,
like,
you get
you,
me?
Yeah, like, if we're going to love people, and okay, first, the greatest two commandments are love the Lord your God with all your... Oh, wait, no, that's a verse. But the greatest two commandments are basically love God and love people. That's basically what it is. And that's kind of the basis of Christianity. And I've always thought that, you know, and I want to be very clear when I say this. It is great to memorize Bible verses. It is great to be in church every single Sunday. Like, that is amazing. And I want to be very clear that those are things that we should do. And I also want to say, like...
To be ready, man.
Yeah.
Put on the armor of God and having that readiness to be willing to go out there, show His Word, be His Word, mm-hmm. and be ready with it.
Yeah. And I was going to say, like, to me, above anything else you ever do, you know, if you go up to somebody and you start talking to them about Scripture, I think that is great. But I really, truly think the way you impact people the most is your relationships with them and how you... love them. Christianity to me is love. And gosh, we've probably said love like 40 times this episode, but that's what like the topic of it.
That's how important it is, man.
Dude, that's how important it is. Like, I truly, truly think love is the most powerful thing in the entire universe. And I know that sounds kind of cosmic or whatever. Or that sounds all like, you know, huge. I mean, I really do think, like, you know, I always say love will always drive out fear. Like, love is just so powerful. And I mean, that unconditional love is just something that is amazing and something that we can't do on our own. Like, only God can show us unconditional love. And
we try to get to there with that. And the whole concept of love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you,
mm-hmm.
that's also trying to get to that unconditional love.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think we'll ever reach that because, of course, we're not God and we cannot be perfect.
Well, yeah.
We should be striving to get to that level.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, I think about it with, like, you know, like friendships, okay? You know, like we talked about what it means to be a good friend, and you know, we were saying not always your interests or, you know, like all those things will, like, you know, make a great friend. To me, a great friend is loyalty and love. And it's like, you know, like I, you know, like I said the other night, you know, when Hud asked me to go like do something with him, I mean, I really didn't want to, but I was like, man, I love Hud. He's my boy. I love him. And, you know, I'm loyal as a friend. Like, we're loyal to each other. And I was like, you know, I got to get out and I got to do this because I love him enough to help him. You know what I mean?
That's that brotherly love, man. And me coming close to falling and you being there to help me, man, that's what God's called us to do in our lives. And I know that I would do that at a drop of the hat for you too.
Yeah.
I mean, and I think we should all strive for that. Some relationships these days are like, what can I get out of you?
For sure.
What can you help me with? Me. And when it should be, what can I do to glorify God,
mm-hmm,
and show him to these people?
Yeah. And I mean, it's crazy to me. Like, some people, you know, they'll just, I don't even know how to say it. Like, we all want something from someone else. Oh, like,
yeah, I get that.
Like, oh, okay, let me use this story. So my coach, Coach Bandy, shout out to Coach Bandy. It's my guy, you know, Primetime Lab. He told us something the other day. You know, he was asking us, he's like, how do you love people? Like, how do you show people you love them and stuff like that? And like, how are people loyal to you? So he put out like a contest. He was like, all right, you know, tag somebody in this and repost it on your story, and you can win this bag. And he was saying, you know, he was like, I had 30, 40, 50 people repost that all because they wanted something. He's like, how many of those people, I don't want to say how many of those people, but how many people message me just like, you know, in general? Like, those people that wanted something. Yeah. And he was not, and like, and I want to make this clear. He was saying, that's not a bad thing. Obviously, it was, you know,
it's human nature, dude, to want and to.
Yeah, well, obviously, it was a prize, or it was like a contest. So, I mean, if there's a contest and you have a chance to win something, like, you're going to put it in it. But he was using that to say that people are going to get more involved in things when there's something that they can benefit from or something they want.
To be won or anything like that. Yeah, I get that.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, when it comes to our relationships and when it comes to what we do, unconditional is literally, like, it's a word we've used a lot, but it's just crazy, like, what it means. Like, you literally cannot fathom unconditional love. You cannot, like, put a cap on it. You can't, like, it's everlasting. And what that means is, like, you wake up every single day and it becomes more and more and more and more every single day. Like, you wake up, you know, ready to... just to love in general.
And that should be our goal every day, is to wake up and say, how can I show that?
It's a choice.
I mean, it's a choice when you do that. And you get it all the time when, like you said, somebody's at the gym, you know, y'all are getting into it. Like, hey, your shot's broke, dude. Like, I mean, they're in your ear.
A garbage can.
I mean, what are they going to do? You look at them and tell you, man, hey, I love you, dude. I don't care what you say to me.
Yeah.
But I'm going to love you.
You know, I've ran into that. It's kind of crazy you say that. I've ran into that before. Like, I've ran into people. You know, when I was younger, I mean, I did kind of have a little, I don't want to say like an issue, but like, I mean, I trash talked and stuff. And the older I got, you know, my uncle just kind of told me, he's like, you know, that stuff, like, that's actually the moments you have to influence somebody. Like, whenever, even when you're playing, you know, whenever... you know, a method he gave me, and for all my little hoopers out there that are listening, you know, he gave me a method, and I was like, well, what am I supposed to do when I feel like talking trash? He's like, well, take that energy out on your teammates. As in, like, when you feel like saying something
positive.
Yeah, it's like, turn it into a positive. Like, he was like, so whenever you feel like hating on another person, turn it into love, and, like, look at your teammates. You know, if you feel like talking to somebody on the other team, like, look at one of your teammates and say, hey, great pass. Great passer. Hey, great screen. Hey, come on, we need to do this. Hey, come on, we need to do that.
Build them up.
Yeah, and build them up. Instead of, like, looking to tear somebody else down, like, build somebody else up.
And it really bothers me, because I lay down at night and think of all the times I've missed an opportunity to show that love. Instead of reaching out to somebody and just like that, not talking back or something like that, and I'm like, man, I bit my tongue on that. Why didn't I say this? Why didn't I say that?
Mm-hmm.
But if you're constantly trying to grow, you'll get there. It takes time and it takes patience, but
yeah, you know how we say like love is a choice? You know, God gave us a choice. Like, God gave us free will for a reason. And, you know, a lot of people ask, you know, why we have free will. Well, how are we supposed to, like really love somebody if we don't let them love us, I guess? You know what I mean? So it's like, if we were all robots and we were just like, I love you. And we just all, like, loved each other.
What's the point of living, dude?
Well, it's just like, we're not, like, we're different. We're all different. And we are all specifically made different, like, in love. And what I mean by that is, like, God gave us free will because he wants us to love him willingly. Like I said, you know, I mean, you can't force somebody to love you. Like, you can give them all you have. You can give every single ounce of everything you have in you for them. And, you know, I mean, it is the choice, like I said. And I personally feel like, you know, if you really know what God's love is like, loving him, you'll want that choice. Like, and you'll know.
The free will, dude. I have to talk about this, but I saw this awesome demonstration of free will. It was, somebody asked, why do we have free will if God knows what we're going to do?
Ooh, that's kind of deep.
And I was like, yeah. And a guy said, think about it this way. You get two boxers, and you go back and you watch them on YouTube.
Rocky and Creed.
Okay, let's say you're...
Rocky and Creed, let's go, baby.
All right, let's say you're watching Rocky and Creed. You go back on that YouTube, and you're watching that. You already know the outcome. That's like God. Yeah. Since he's outside of time, he already knows the outcome.
But we still watch it.
But it's letting, like, yeah. And it's letting them yeah. play through it. Yeah. And I thought that was crazy. I was like, you know, since time doesn't even touch him, and we can't hardly fathom that, but it doesn't even touch him, so he knows how it's going to play out. But it can still play out differently in a way because you have the options.
Right.
But he, I mean, it already knows, you know? It's yeah, like yeah, watching yeah. that fight. You know what's going to happen. But in that time they're fighting, they don't know what's happening.
Right, yeah. They don't know, but, like, you know, but he knows. I mean, that's really crazy. I've honestly never thought about it that way. And, you know, I've struggled with anxiety and stuff like that before. And, you know, I've had to learn, you know, that when I give it up to him, and that's the best way to deal with it, and that's the best way, like, that's the best medicine, is really just knowing that he loves me and he cares for me and that, you know, he wants the best for me and that, you know, I don't have to, you know, be like that. Like, I can give that up to him.
He'll fight those demons for you, bro.
Yeah.
He'll fight those struggles and the anxiety you have. You put that on him and he's got that, you know?
Right. And, oh yeah, and he's got that, you know, like I've been wearing a shirt a lot lately. It says God's got me on it, and my friend Gunnar Person, he's a trainer in Missouri, and you know, he started that brand. It's like the God's got me. I guess it's like his brand, but it, you know, the shirts say God's got me on it, and I've been wearing it, and I've been trying to find my confidence and my joy in that, you know, knowing that, you know, God's got me, and that whenever I, you know, look to him and put my confidence in him, that, you know, things are going to work out for me. Like, I'm going to, you know, ultimately, like, just be a more confident person.
Yeah, and I think a great verse is 1 Peter 4:8, and it says, there is no fear in love. And in saying that, I can think of the way that if I have these fears, these demons, I can give that to God because he is that love.
Right.
You know, and that love is always there for you to comfort you and be there for you and take any, doesn't matter what circumstance it is, but to just be confident in yourself.
Yeah,
because you got that love.
And you know, speaking of, like, you know, self-confidence, like you talk about, talk about a little bit about, like, what you've put your confidence in before and how it's failed you.
Okay, so this might sound a little self-conceited in a way, but I've always been kind of confident in myself, which isn't always a bad thing, but too much can be a destruction of anything.
Well, if you're confident in who you are, yeah. Like, okay, you know, I hear Tim Tebow say that a lot. He'll say, we need to forget who we are and remember whose we are. Right. Like, when you remember that you are God's and God's alone, then, you know, when you know whose you are, meaning God's, then you're going to have confidence. But it's yeah. like, we can't put our confidence in ourselves because we're not good enough.
You know, and I struggled with that because I always thought to myself, you know, me being a preacher's kid, talking to everybody, I've always had this sense of
PKs, baby.
I've always had this sense of
I can make it no matter what. Mm-hmm. I got this. I don't need anybody to help me along because I can find my way.
Yeah.
And the more I did that, the more I failed. And when I finally realized, you know, I was like, I just can't do this anymore. I got to give this to God. Like, I need his help in my decision making, and I just can't keep relying on myself because myself isn't enough.
Yeah, and I mean, we're just not good enough, dude. I mean, and a lot of people have heard the term God confidence before, and what that really means is, like, you know, when we have confidence knowing that with God we're strong and that God made us exactly how he wants us. You know, I've felt in that before with, like, being like, man, I want to be like this person, or I want to be like this person. And, you know, we have to know whose we are, and we have to know that God made us exactly how he wants us. Dude, I promise you, it's crazy to me, like, that everybody in the world is different.
Yeah, and he made you that way, and he made you to be specific in his way, you know?
Right.
We're called to be what God wants us to be, not necessarily somebody else is called to be. Mm-hmm. Like say Tim Tebow, you know, that's a great model to look up to.
Mm-hmm.
But your life isn't like his life.
Yeah. I mean, and he's actually talked about that. He's talked about, like, how we need to strive to be the best version of ourselves.
Be the best you can be.
Yeah. And, you know, before we close out, I just want to ask, do you know how loved you are? Like, the person listening right now, do you understand how much God loves you with his unconditional love? Like, you know, God's love is so powerful, and it's amazing. And, like, you know, if you don't know that amazing love, or if you don't think you're loved, like, gosh, that breaks my heart, honestly, like, if you don't understand how loved you are. But, you know, if you don't know that amazing love, open up in your word and dive into it. And, you know, if you don't know how, if you say, Caleb, well, I mean, I don't really know how to read my Bible. A lot of people don't realize that's a common thing.
Yeah, it is. A lot of people struggle with, how do you find these verses? How do you do this? Ask somebody wise, and mm-hmm. you know?
Yeah.
You can go back, you can even go back to Google, say, verses on love, verses on patience, verses on kindness.
Yeah, like, whatever you struggle with, if you struggle with insecurity, if you struggle with whatever, you know, verses to help with insecurity. If you struggle with anxiety, like, I mean, I have verses on anxiety. If you struggle with confidence, you know, verses on confidence. Like, you can look up anything.
There's always an answer for the questions you have, and you just have to find, you got to dig deep sometimes to find mm-hmm. these answers.
Yeah, and, you know, we're no wise men or anything, by no means, but, like, our DMs are always open for questions. Like, if you guys, you know, if you aren't confident or have struggled with something, you know, let us know and we'll help you out. Like, we love you guys, and, you know, we want you to be your best. Like, we're just trying to be our best too. We're just, you know, trying to be our best right now, and we want you guys to be too.
And I want you guys to understand, you know, we're not doing this just to talk, you know. It's not just like to hear our voices or anything like that. We felt called to do this because we want to reach people and help mm-hmm. people, you know. And that goes for anybody. If you have any questions, just let us know. Let somebody know. I mean, there's always help. Don't think you're in it alone like I did for so long with my self-righteousness, in a way.
Yes.
That I thought I can handle everything when I clearly could not. There's always somebody to help you, and there's always God.
Right. And, always. And, you know, like he said about, you know, like, the reason we were called to do this, like, I want to keep it real the whole time, because, like, I've had people tell me, you know, when they listen to an episode, they're like, oh my gosh, like, that resonated with me so much. That's the goal. The goal is not to come out here and to just, you know, be typical, or not typical, but just, like,
or just to preach, you know.
It's like, we're basically literally getting out here and saying we struggle too. Like, we go through the same stuff. Like, we're not going to come out here and just be like, oh, yeah, you know.
Everything's like, great. Everything's fun. Great.
Like, yeah, I know. I mean, like, we struggle, too, with things just like everybody else does. By no means are we perfect, you know. I mean, like, we're struggling, too. And that's why, like, one of our themes is, you know, it's, like, talking about how we just keep it real. Like, people relate to real. And that's just something, like, you know, like, is so important to us.
Yeah, man.
So, you know, Hud's going to close us out with some prayer. And again, you know, if any of you guys have any questions or anything, please feel free, by all means, to, you know, to DM us, give us feedback, you know, like what you liked, what you didn't like. I mean, we're always, you know, down for that. So just give us some feedback, you know, and promise you if you need anything, we're here.
Absolutely. All right, guys.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for just your blessings on blessings and knowing that you're here and you are love and we are loved, Lord. And I'm grateful for this opportunity to reach out to you guys. I'm grateful for God giving me this opportunity to do this, and I can't wait to see the impact it has on you guys and us. And we hope and pray that we fight demons together, and I just pray that he gives us blessings on blessings, guys. And I just love every one of y'all, and I know he does too. And
yes, sir.
I pray that you always call on him, Lord. And just now pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, and when he said blessings on blessings, yeah, you ever... No, I'm not that song. Think about Lecrae. You know, blessings. If I ever had a... I don't know. What does he say?
I ain't following, bro.
You not following?
I ain't following, dude.
Oh, wait. If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson.
Oh.
And then he's like, oh, something about blessings after that, but I don't know.
On blessings.
But, yeah, but guys, go check out Lecrae. He's pretty great. We had to talk about if he's the GOAT or not. He probably is. All right. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and we'll see y'all later. God bless.
God bless, guys. Peace.